Hello and welcome. My name is Johannes Erlacher and I'm going to present the work I did together with Florian Mendel and Maria Eichlseder on bounds for the security of Ascon against linear and differential cryptanalysis. I want to start off with a short note on the motivation behind our work. Over the last couple of years, designs with weak alignments have become more and more popular. We see this, for example, in multiple proposals for the NIST Lightweight Cryptography project. Designs like Zodiac, Ascon, or ISAP all have weak alignments and larger state sizes. For designs like that, if we look at linear or differential cryptanalysis, we usually see a gap between the provable bounds and the best known characteristics. For Ascon, for example, we only have bounds up to 3 rounds, while we have found characteristics far beyond that. This holds for a differential case, as can be seen here, but also for the linear one. These bounds are usually proven by means of MILP, SMT, or constrained programming models, while we are searching for good characteristics using heuristic search tools. With this in mind, I want to focus on recent developments in the encoding of cryptographic primitives as pure Boolean satisfiability problems. Sun et al., for example, have proposed efficient encoding methods for cryptographic functions as part of their analysis of several designs, which is also part of this conference here. We use these encoding methods to derive linear and differential models of the Ascon permutation and were able to verify existing bounds very efficiently. Unfortunately though, we were not able to extend those bounds to more rounds. At the same time, there are also steady developments in the implementation and design of existing Boolean satisfiability solvers. But not only that, there are also new approaches utilizing multiple solver instances in parallel. We evaluated some of those approaches, but unfortunately did not see any major runtime improvements there. Therefore, we started to think about a manual parallelization approach utilizing these new encoding methods, with the goal of proving new bounds for the Ascon permutation. Such an approach would need to partition the search space into many independent problems. These problems could then be tackled in parallel utilizing multiple solver instances. To keep the runtime reasonable, we further want to reduce the complexity of these individual tasks. We can do this by optimizing the approach itself, but also the underlying SAT model we are using. Before I go into more details on the approach, I want to introduce Ascon, the target of our evaluations. The Ascon family builds upon a permutation used in sponge or duplex constructions. This permutation is defined via a state of 320 bits consisting of 5 64-bit words, as can be seen on the slides here. This state is transformed over several rounds by two main layers. Namely, a substitution layer is applied column-wise and provides confusion, while we have a linear layer providing diffusion within each of the 5 words. These two layers are repeated over several rounds, where the number of rounds depends on the variant in which it's used. The most common configurations are 6, 8, and 12 rounds, with a single round configuration used within ISAP. To give you a little bit more details, the linear layer provides diffusion within each word by applying a linear function. This linear function is defined as a bitwise XOR over rotated versions of each word. The substitution layer, on the other hand, uses a 5-bit SBox applied 64 times column-wise. This SBox has a maximum differential probability of 2 to the power of minus 2 with the same maximum linear bias. Our approach requires us to model these layers as Boolean satisfiability problems. Therefore, we follow the approach from Sun et al. For us, each intermediate state bit is represented by one Boolean variable. Therefore, the encoding of a layer can be seen as a Boolean function with 320 input and output variables. If you look at the encoding for a substitution layer, for example, this encoding would restrict the input and output variables such that they are only allowed to represent valid entries in the DDT or LAT of the SBox, respectively. Since we are interested in finding new bounds, we we also need to represent the weight of the S-box transitions in some way. Therefore, we encode an additional 64 variables representing the S-box activity in each round. This set of variables can then be used to limit the total maximum active S-boxes in our model. The linear layer, on the other hand, simply constrains its input and output variables such that they represent the linear function I presented earlier. With this general overview, I want to continue with our manual parallelization approach. So in order to prove the non-existence of any characteristic up to a certain number of active S-boxes, one needs to consider all possible characteristics within the search space. To utilize multiple solver instances, we need to derive independent subproblems from this search space. Each of these problems should then consider as many cases as possible while still being efficiently solvable. One potential idea for this is to categorize characteristics by the S-box activity. We can observe that multiple characteristics share a common S-box activity pattern within certain rounds. In order to derive a pattern, a partitioning approach from this, I want to introduce the concept of the girdle pattern. The girdle pattern for us is the S-box activity within the round with the fewest active S-boxes. For example, I've included here the S-box activities for the currently best known differential characteristic over four rounds of Ascon. Round 2 is the girdle round with its girdle pattern for this specific characteristic. It has a total of 3 active S-boxes, and which we refer to as the girdle weight. For this specific case and for this specific characteristic, also round 3 fulfills our definition of the girdle pattern. So in order to derive a partitioning from this, we would fix a specific girdle pattern in a specific round in our SAT model. If we run this model, we would simultaneously check all characteristics which fulfill, which have this specific girdle pattern in this specific round. To give you a little bit more details, so the properties of this are that the girdle round for any characteristic can be in any round. So for our partitioning, we need to consider every girdle pattern in every round. The second point I want to make here is much more interesting. Since the girdle round requires all other rounds to have at least as many active S-boxes, on the other hand, we can say that there is an upper limit to how many active S-boxes the girdle round has. So we do not need to consider all possible patterns, but only up to the maximum weight of the girdle round. To give you an idea of this, let's take the example of 4 rounds with a bound of at most 35 active S-boxes. For this, we would need to consider all possible girdle patterns up to a weight of 8. This gives us a total of 2 to the power of 32 different patterns we have to consider. Each of those patterns would then need to be fixed in our model in all different rounds and run for each experiment separately. With this, we have achieved the partitioning of our search space, but we still have open questions. First of all, we have a huge number of individual checks we now have to make. Probably we can reduce this number. The second point is the complexity of these individual subproblems is still relatively high because the complexity of our model grows with the number of rounds we have to encode and also the bound we have to encode. Therefore, I want to first consider rotational symmetries in the Ascon permutation. So we can observe that characteristics for the Ascon permutation are actually rotational invariant. This means that rotating each word of a characteristic by a constant value gives us an equivalent valid characteristic. And this property also applies to our definition of the girdle pattern. So for example, if we take this these internal states I've included here on the slides over one round of Ascon, and we shift them by 3, for example, we get an equivalent characteristic in terms of structure and weight. So With this in mind, we can eliminate duplicates from our search space. And we do this by applying necklace theory. Necklace theory can be used to enumerate all rotational unique patterns of a certain length with a given weight. For us, this length would be 64, given the Xbox activity, and the weight would be defined by the different weights we have to check for each girdle pattern. Overall, this reduces the number of patterns we have to check by a factor of 2 to the power of 6, and gives us a rotational unique set of girdle necklaces, which removes redundant checks from our search space. So with this, we only have to solve the last problem here, which is to reduce the complexity of the individual problems. For this, we can make another observation. Given a characteristic over, for example, 4 rounds with a girdle pattern in the first or second round, this is the same girdle pattern here. For these characteristics, they share a common precondition, namely that they must contain a partial characteristic over 3 rounds with the specific girdle pattern in the first round. A similar property holds for a characteristic with a girdle pattern in the third or fourth round over 4 rounds. With this in mind, we can, first of all, only check patterns, all the patterns over 3 rounds, and only if this precondition holds, we will consider them for full round checks in their specific cases. This reduces the model complexity in 2 ways. First of all, it reduces the number of rounds we have to encode, but second of all, since the girdle round requires all other rounds to have at least as many active S-boxes, we can also reduce the bound we are checking for this reduced model by the weight of the girdle round. So now we have a partitioning without redundant checks, and with this pre-filtering approach, we can first of all check all our patterns in a reduced way, with reduced complexity and also only consider certain rounds instead of all of them. Finally, I also want to mention that in our paper, we describe further optimization approaches, like combining similar subtasks into one and an evaluation of different methods to encode the bound in our SUT model. I want to continue with the results we were able to acquire using this new approach, starting with a new bound for 4 rounds of Ascon. Our goal here was to prove at least 36 active S-boxes over 4 rounds. We therefore need to consider all girdle necklaces with weights up to 8. This gives us a total of 2 to the power of 26 different patterns we have to consider. We first of all do our pre-filtering over 3 rounds, checking all these patterns in the first and third round. This pre-filtering is very successful because only very few patterns actually fulfill this precondition. There are around 4,000 patterns for the differential and linear case left. These patterns have an interesting difference in their distribution for the linear and differential case. In the differential case, these lower weight patterns are favored in the first round, in the initial round, while the linear case favors these lower weight patterns in the last round. This makes intuitive sense since the diffusion in the backwards direction is much larger for the linear case. These pre-filtered patterns are then, of course, rechecked over the full 4 rounds for the respective cases. Overall, these experiments took around 600 CPU days for the linear and differential case each. We executed those experiments in around half a week on 176 cores. The runtime is dominated by the pre-filtering checks for patterns of weight 8. This makes sense since they contribute the largest number of individual patterns. Overall, we can conclude that we did not find any satisfiable instances, and therefore a single characteristic for 4 rounds of Ascon must have at least 36 active S-boxes. With this new 4-round bound, we wanted to extend our approach to even more rounds, and therefore target a 6-round bound for Ascon as well. For this, we can make this observation that any characteristic with at most 53 active S-boxes over 6 rounds must contain a partial characteristic with less than 27 active S-boxes in its first or last 3 rounds, as visualized on the slides here. For this, we can additionally reuse our pre-filtering results from the 4-round experiments, since these cover this bound of less than 27 already. The only thing we have to do is extend those pre-filtering results for the 2nd round case, since we previously only considered the 1st and 3rd round. With this in mind, we can do the following approach. We consider all pre-filtered patterns over 3 rounds and check these patterns in their respective case in the 1st and 2nd half over 6 rounds. This means, for example, a pre-filtered pattern in the 1st round over 3 rounds would then be rechecked over 6 rounds in the 1st and 4th round. A similar case applies to the 2nd and 3rd round patterns as well. If none of these checks yield a satisfiable instance, we can conclude that this bound holds as well. We did all of those experiments in around 60 CPU days for the linear and differential case each. The pre-filtered patterns we had to consider were around 6,000 for each case. Therefore, the additional 2nd round pre-filtering results contributed around 2,000 patterns to each case. In conclusion, we can say that we did not find any satisfiable instances, and therefore also this bound of at least 54 active S-boxes over 6 rounds of Ascon holds. With these new bounds established, I want to take a look at the implications for Ascon. From our results, we can derive 3 new interesting bounds, namely a 6, an 8, and a 12-round bound. First of all, let's take a look at the authenticated encryption schemes. There, the initialization and finalization phases both use 12-round configurations of this permutation. Our 12-round bound, which is almost certainly not tight, already provides an ample security margin for 128-bit security there. The data processing, on the other hand, uses 6 and 8-round configurations. There, we can only make this argument that with a data limit of 2 to the power of 64 encryption blocks per key, it is very unlikely with our new bounds to find pairs among those queries. But we are working towards extending the 6-round bound to a probability of at least 2 to the power of -128. So finally, I want to mention Ascon hash and Ascon XOF. These are unkeyed modes and therefore hard to evaluate based on probability. We can make this intuitive argument there based on the assumption that if we have 2 to the power of 128 attempts, utilizing all degrees of freedom the rate provides, so 64 bits, we would get a probability of 2 to the power of -192. While our 12-round bound, which is almost certainly not tight, already implies a probability of 2 to the power of -216. So this gives confidence in the resistance of those schemes against such attack vectors. With this, I want to give you an outlook of potential future work. So a bound of at least 40 active S-boxes over 4 rounds should be possible with our approach. We estimate a runtime of around 6.6 thousand CPU days, which was unfortunately beyond our computational budget. Another interesting bound would be at least 64 active S-boxes over 6 rounds, which are already mentioned. This might only be possible if we only consider constrained characteristics though. Since our bounds are almost certainly not tight, we did not specifically evaluate probability bounds, but the modeling techniques by Sun et al. Are most certainly able to model such to derive such models as well. Finally, I want to mention the application to other designs. There are other designs which share similar structure to Ascon, as well as some designs having this rotational invariant property as well. So therefore, our approach is generally applicable to other designs as well. So to summarize, I've presented a manual parallelization approach with which we were able to derive new bounds for the Ascon permutation, namely a bound of at least 36 differential or linear active S boxes over 4 rounds, as well as at least 54 differential or linear active S boxes over 6 rounds. These bounds are almost certainly not tight, but they are enough to support trust in this permutation. With this, I want to thank you for your attention and have a nice day.